Hey YouTube, I'm back. Usually, of course, I am back with the juice because something, for some reason, my life is really juicy. And maybe it's not juicy, it's just really fun to hear about. Yeah, some juices happened. I mean, hence the title. I wanted this video a little different, actually, because it will help you better understand the situation from my point of view. This is a real situation. I couldn't make this stuff up. This is a real situation, something that actually and really happened to me recently. Very fresh. But I mean, it's better when it's fresher, I think, to give it to you. I actually had another video planned, but I was like, scratch this. This one about to be 10 times better. They gonna love it. But yeah. I don't really notice it, but me and my friend were having a conversation. Well, not me and my friends, me and actually some stranger would have a conversation about the situation or about life in general. And apparently I have like a multiple personality disorder. Honestly, I think all females do. And this is where my females can all relate to this video. Something recently, like a situation just popped off. And I really got in touch with all the parts of myself in that situation. There's a regular me, apparently, a ratchet me, and a high sedity bitch, I don't give a fuck me. And these all came into play when this happened, okay? Yeah, I'm really gonna just appear even more crazier when this video is done, but you guys must love the crazy! You're subscribing, you're liking, you're viewing. But this is a real scenario. So recently I've been talking to a guy. Been talking for roughly like 4 months. And we have already made plans and stuff to meet up with each other, because actually it's long distance, because he's actually in California and I'm here in North Carolina. So it's like a 2,000 mile difference. And I've actually like made plans and things for us to get up and to see each other. And he hits me with a doozy. And yeah, let's just see how I reacted to that. Sorry? About what?
No type of way. If you feel some type of way.
Hell yeah. Shit. Oh, my boo text me. It's my boo. He text me in. Called him all day. What? You must be joking. Who is it now? Fuck. Telling you niggas ain't shit. So you gotta keep them lined up. I have to be honest with you, I met someone locally? Wow. Like, I really invested a lot of time, in to this dude. I mean, I understand we're really, really far away, but I really invested my time.
Yeah.
You gotta be kidding me. You gotta be kidding me. He just ruined. You gotta be kidding me. He found somebody locally? Really? Really? You disappear for a day. Don't text me at all. When you finally text me, you text me a freaking sorry? Sorry, my nigga? You sorry, my nigga? Yo, somebody please tell me this nigga did not just waste 4 months of my precious time to tell me he's sorry he found somebody locally. Whoa, well, I need to give myself a minute to calm down. I need to give myself a minute to calm down. Somebody kidding me. This is a joke, right? It's a joke. April Fool's early. That dude is funny as hell. Because this better be a fucking joke. I'm not playing.
So after 4 months, you decide that you'd rather have someone locally. Mind you, only days before you decided to tell me you found somebody locally, I actually asked you about it and you assured me that we had a connection. A connection? Since when does convenience surpass a connection? I know. No, it's my bad. It's really me. It's my bad for being naive. It's my bad for actually thinking for a second you felt the way I did, or thinking that you can handle a situation so sensitive.
No, you did not find somebody locally. No, you didn't. You know what? I'm about to text this nigga right now and tell him that he owe me some fucking money. Because I didn't pay $300 for no plane tickets. Got me making reservations and shit for hotels I'm never going to get to stay in because he found somebody locally? Oh, my blood pressure. Oh, my God. My blood pressure. I can't even see this shit. I'm about to Skype. You know what? Fuck this. I'm about to Skype this nigga. Skype, FaceTime, because I'm really pissed. I can't even see what the fuck a phone number is. Somebody please, Jesus. You know what? Fuck, I don't even want my money back. You know why I don't want my money back? Because I'm going. I don't even give a fuck. I'm going. I got a nigga address too. Where is my...
I'm not even mad. You just opened up a whole bunch of free time for when I get to Cali. It honestly is what it is, I guess. Like, I can't even be mad about it. I think I'm more hurt about the fact that you actually convinced me. You reassured me we had something, even after I showed my concern that maybe this wasn't going to work. You assured me it was okay, and I was crazy, and I knew everything about you, and you really, really liked me, and we had a connection? How could I have been so stupid? I mean, at the end of the day, you win some, you lose some. Again, I mean, I'm not new to it. Not even mad about it. Do you, boo.
because I'm about to. This is going to be the farthest I ever had to go for some. This is about to be the farthest I ever had to go to cut the fuck up. This nigga do not know me. Can somebody please? Oh my God. I'm about to blank out because I'm really pissed. You know what? I only want my $300 back because I'm about to go up this nigga ass. That's all that's about to happen. I'm about to call Southwest and tell them and see if there's any way they can bump my tickets up to tonight because I'm about to kill a nigga. As soon as I find this address, what the fuck is my pocket knife? I'm about to stab this nigga tires because I ain't about to go all the way to California for nothing.
Bro, you answered quick. Yes. Yeah. You know, I told you that. About last week. Oh, I know it's been a minute. I know I was just calling, you know, see what you're doing. I was gonna be out in Cali in a few months. Yes. Oh my God, I'd love to get up with you. I've been busy, but I've been thinking about you though, babe. I've really been thinking about you. Yes. No, I can't wait to see you. No. Yeah, you'll have me the whole week. How are you from far? Are you from LA again?
It's like, wow. It's like I kind of knew this shit was gonna happen.
He's gonna lose his fucking life messing with me because I don't do this. I don't do this. She gonna lose his life messing with me because I don't do this. Nigga don't know me. Yeah, that's pretty much how it happened. I couldn't make this shit up if I tried. I want to say that it's horrible to have to go through and deal with, but at the same time, it makes for a good-ass story. God knows, I love telling some really good and juicy stories. And that was one. But, yeah. The best thing to do about a situation like that is to talk about it, go through it, and get over it quick. But, anyway, it is what it is, and I will be coming March. I will be in California. Yay! And I will apparently have lots of free time. Yay! So, I'd love to do a meetup and meet some of you people that if you're in California, I'm not sure how many subscribers are in California or how many will come between now and March that are gonna be in California, but I will be in California. I'm actually going to do LA, and then I'll be in the Bay Area also. So, I'll keep you guys posted on when that's going to be and keep you up to date. And then I'll let you know when I'm going there and a week before and all that crap. Do the best I can, you know, I'm a slacker. But, yeah, that was it for today. And this is for my females because they know more than anybody how this is and how it can be. But that basically was the story. It is what it is. I'm not upset. I'm not mad about it. To each his own. Do you. Do what makes you feel good. Like I said before, I ain't even mad at you. Play on. But again, YouTube, I love you guys. Keep subscribing. If this is the first video you viewed, you have to view the rest, but this is probably the best. But yes, rate, comment, subscribe, email me, whatever, hit me up, kick me on Instagram. I haven't got my Facebook. I'm about to start a Tumblr. And yes, my beauty page is coming, and it's going to be geared towards dark-skinned women. I'm not sure if anybody on YouTube even doing it, but yes. Beginning of January, I will be doing a beauty page about dark-skinned women's nails, hair, makeup, clothes, everything, because dark skin is a different breed of woman. I mean, I'm just saying. But yes, you too. I love you guys. Rate, comment, subscribe. Thank you for my viewers that are all been viewing, that are faithfully viewing. I love you guys. See you next time.